Good morning, my lovely students. Hopefully, you all have given your best in first term exams. Resume your previous routine and get ready for second unit test with same zeal. And pray to Almighty for those happy hours of proper school routine. Okay, students, take out your diary or any copy and note down the syllabus for second unit test. Write down subject science, syllabus for second unit test. It will be in the month of November. Lesson 3, birds. Lesson 7, solids, liquids and gases. Two chapters will come in the second unit test. Lesson 3, birds. Lesson 7, solids, liquids and gases. Okay, students, take out your books. Page number 1919, lesson 3, birds. Underline birds. Write down day. Do reading. Children, I'm going to tell you few points about birds. Birds have body parts like claws, beaks, feathers and wings, etc. Most of the birds can fly in the air. When birds fly, their wings move up and down in two directions. Okay, while flying, their wings move up and down in two directions. A bird's body is covered with different type of feathers. Okay, it is covered with different types of feathers. The shape of the bird's beak depends on the kind of the food it eats. Understood? The shape of the bird's beak, it depends on the kind of food it eats. Birds use their feet and claws to walk, hop and sit on the branches of the trees. What they use? To walk, hop and sit on the branches of the trees. They use their feet and claws. You know, children, what is a home? What is a nest? What is the home of the bird? That is the nest. A nest is a home of birds. What is a nest? It is a home of birds. They use different type of the things to build their nest. They lay eggs in the nest. Okay, children. Now we will do reading, page number 1919. Birds are feathered winged animals with a beak. Understood? They are egg-laying animals. They are egg-laying animals. A bird's body comprises of a head with a beak, a trunk with wings, feathers and legs with claws. Understood? Bird's body comprises of a head with a beak. Underline. A trunk with wings, underline, feathers and legs with claws. Okay, now we'll do parts of a bird's body. See, look here. It is the head. It is the crown, eye, beak, throat. It's the breast, down feathers, claws. These are claws. Feet, leg, is a tail, these are wings. Understood? Eye, crown, head, beak, throat, breast, down feathers, claws, feet, leg, tail and wings. Children, you know how do birds fly? Underline. I'll make you understand. Most birds can fly in the air. Number one, the wings of the birds help them to fly. The wings of the birds help them to fly. The wings are attached to the body with the help of muscles. Underline. These muscles help the wings to move. What is the function of the muscles? These muscles help the wings to move. Underline. Number two, they have hollow and light bones which make their bodies very light. They have hollow and light bones which make their bodies very light. Number three, the streamlined or board-shaped body of the birds help them to fly through their air easily. The streamlined or board-shaped body of the birds help them to fly through the air easily. Rise for 2 minutes. Okay, students, number four, the tails of the birds help them to change direction while flying. Okay, who help them to change the direction while flying? The tails of the birds help them to change direction while flying. What they use while changing the direction? To change the direction, what they use? That use tails of the birds help them to change direction while flying. When birds fly, their wings move up and down in two directions. You know, children, when birds fly, their wings move up and down in two directions. Number one, upstroke movement. Number two, downstroke movement. The downward and forward movement of birds is called downstroke movement. The upward and backward movement of the bird is called upstroke movement. The upward and backward movement of the bird is called upstroke movement. And the downward and forward movement of bird is called downstroke movement. Underline, revise for 2 minutes.